Mike the Bee, theme music, Mike the Bee, theme music. You never know where he's gonna be, he's just gonna be Mike the Bee, theme music.
Hello my little flowers, today I'm coming to you live from Sneech Beach. That's right, we're starting on the island side today. We're here to catch some Death Eaters over in Hogsmeade. They should be out around the time the sun sets today, and the sun's setting a little earlier, so maybe we'll get a little extra time with the eaters today. There is still a few weeks left for Halloween Horror Nights, so we'll see if we get over to the other side and, you know, kind of do some repeats or whatnot, whatever we can get into tonight. Make sure you check out our rankings. We did rank all the houses and the scare zones for Halloween Horror Nights 31. So don't forget to kind of like, follow, subscribe, all that good stuff, and check out that video. So with all that being said, let's go.
We stop by Confisco Grill to get ourselves a bite to eat, where world travelers find international taste. This exotic port of entry establishment offers global fare influenced by Asian, Mediterranean, Greek, and other cuisines. From chilled tuna noodle bowls and pad thai to sweet and sour sticky ribs, a children's menu, and full bar service, there's something to fill up the whole family. Look around to see confiscated goods on display from all over the park. As you pass through Port of Entry, you will find Confisco Grill to the right as you enter the Islands of Adventure. If you take a look around, you'll notice its eclectic hodgepodge decor, which reflects that of Port of Entry. You may also notice some items that have been collected or confiscated from travels throughout the islands. I felt very welcome in its casual and relaxed atmosphere. So we decided to start with the pumpkin hummus as an appetizer. It is a vegan option if you're looking for such. It's savory pumpkin hummus, toasted pepitas, pomegranate seeds, smoked paprika, and chai seeds with charred pita and herb lavash crackers. So I did enjoy this as an appetizer, although the flavor overall tasted very muted to me. When I got the seed and the spice with the hummus, it did create a sweet and savory flavor profile. But it just kind of tasted like plain hummus. I didn't get a whole lot of pumpkin, and I feel like there could have been a little bit more spice. So although it was good, I probably won't be getting this again. My partner got himself a sangria by the glass. Burgundy, apricot and cherry brandy, apple cranberry and orange juice. He said it was your standard red sangria, but it was quite delicious. My partner also went with the pad thai, rice noodles, mixed vegetables, bean sprouts, chicken and shrimp tossed in a house-made peanut sauce. He did say the shrimp was a little heavy on the fishy taste, but other than that, the rest of the dish was very nice and flavorful. I went with the penne alla vodka, grilled Italian sausage, calamata olives, blistered cherry tomatoes, crispy pinocchini, tossed in a light tomato vodka cream sauce. This dish was absolutely delightful, so flavorful and delicious, definitely worth a repeat. After dinner, we made our way over to Hogsmeade to wait for the sun to set to see if the Death Eaters were going to make an appearance. Will got some wand practice in while the sun was still up to be on the ready. Alright guys, it's time to find some Easter eggs. If you make your way to Dervish and Bangs and go inside the shop, look up onto the second story and you will see two sleeping bags hanging over the banisters. We're told these bags were actually screen-used props from a scene when the kids are on lockdown and sleeping within the Great Hall. We were also told that there are two globes located on the shelves that were also screen-used, although there was no confirmation on which globes they were. Soon, the sun will set and we will be face to face with Death Eaters, devoted followers of Lord Voldemort known for their allegiance and practice of the dark arts. As they appear, they will eerily roam and lurk throughout Hogsmeade.
Thank you. even in the darkest of times, if one only remembers to turn on the light.
So we made our way over to the Universal Studios Florida side just to see if we could squeeze in a few minutes of Halloween Horror Nights, for there's only a few weeks left. We decided to take a quick break at the San Francisco Pastry Company and get a few sweet treats. We had to get our favorite, the Jack-O-Lantern Pumpkin Spice Mousse. This tastes just like a pumpkin pie in mousse form. You've got to get this before it's gone. We did try the Petite Cookies and Cream. Cookies and cream mousse layered with cake was actually quite enjoyable once you shoveled through the thick layer of chocolate on the top. We headed over to Diagon Alley to get a matter straightened out, and while we were there, we did a little shopping. They have these really pretty stockings for Christmas. They're $30, and they come in the different house crests. They have these U-Ball costume ornaments. They are $21.95 each, or you can get six for $100. So this is a new backpack I haven't seen before. It's $49.95, and it looks like it's a pretty good size if you're looking for something for the park. They have the Love Potion crossbodies for $82. So remember that little matter I said we had to take care of? We ran into a team member over in Hogsmeade that said that he had the real Elder Wand, and he showed us this wand, which he said he got from the wand shop. Upon investigation, this wand is also called the Elder Wand, but that's because it's made from elder wood. Learning this information put my partner at ease, for he is the owner of the Elder Wand, which is part of the Deathly Hallows. My wand is the other version of the Elder Wand, known as the Rowan Wand, and it is lighter in color. The wood is reserved for its powers of protection. Rowan people are full of healing energy, and they delight in helping others. Rowan people should use their powerful imagination and resourceful nature to make their dreams come true. Weasley's Wizard Wheezy's has some really cute merchandise. This is a t-shirt for $35. This one is $38, and it says new shirts are the same, probably because of the tie-dye portion of the shirt. You can get actual Love Potion for $9.95. It's time once again for Find the Egg. Did you know that these toys found on the shelf are modeled after the first toys that were imported from Japan after World War II? Unfortunately, these are not for sale, but this is a fun little Easter egg hidden within the Weasley shop. We made a stop into Sugar Plums to get a few more sweets while we were visiting Diagon Alley. We decided on a pumpkin pastry and a piece of the infamous Butterbeer fudge. The pumpkin pastry was a basic pumpkin turnover, and although it was good, it needed a little maybe sugar or something on the top, and then it would be perfect. The Butterbeer fudge was okay. The white chocolate fudge on top was a little bit too much and muted the Butterbeer flavoring on the bottom. So I think a little less of the white chocolate and more of the butterscotch would make this fudge a lot better. We did go through our favorite house one more time this year, Dead Man's Pier, Winter Wake. We took our time and really got to look at some of the set pieces and costumes. This truly is an amazing house this year and definitely number one over all 10 houses at this year's event.
Guys, so that's gonna do it for us tonight here at Halloween Horror Nights 31. We got a couple more weeks left to go of the season and then it will be over. So we're basically just gonna be revisiting some of the stuff that we really, really enjoyed about this season. So I hope you keep following us along on these wonderful adventures. We'll try to give you some more tips and tricks along the way if we can. Otherwise, just come along, have some fun with us. As always, I'm Mike the Bee. You never know where I'm going to be. I'm just going to be you be too. I'll see you guys later. Bye!